Hey guys, what's going on? It's Lefty from 643 Productions coming at you here with a Modern Warfare 3 Team Deathmatch gameplay commentary. Here I am in the map Village using the ACR 6.8, looking sexy in gold. As always, this gameplay is part of the Quack Clan Revival Tour coming to a Team Deathmatch server near you. Now, this video is in response to some of the criticism or comments, I guess you could say, that I received on the video I did about Robert Bowling 402, as you guys know him on Twitter, resigning from his position as lead of the Modern Warfare series and creative strategist of Infinity Ward and as an employee of Activision. Now, right around this time, again, it happened at the time this video is going to be going up, it happened a few days ago, and there was a big race among YouTube for people to put out videos on this. Of course, it was a hot topic. A lot of people were talking about it. A lot of people wanted to know about it, and everybody wanted to put out videos on it. I was one of them, of course. I like to keep you guys updated on what's going on, and I thought it was pretty big news. At least it's something to talk about. And people, again, a lot of people were asking me for my opinions on it and what I know about it, so of course I did a video. But Woody's Gamer Tag did a video, and there are a few other people that did a video like or with the similar or a similar tone that Woody did his video. And right around the time, because mine was the first of the people that I'm subscribed to, though again I'm only subscribed to like 25 people or so. I like to keep my my feed cluttered, or I like to keep my feed from being cluttered from people that, you know, from videos that I don't really find interesting and stuff like that. But anyway, right about the time that Woody's video dropped about the subject, I started receiving a ton of comments on my video about 402 resigning that really reflected the rhetoric that Woody portrayed in that video. And the rhetoric was that still to this day, that Robert Bowling isn't really anybody. He was just a scapegoat. He's just a guy that people seized upon to outlet their rage, or as an outlet for their rage at a game. And he's not the guy at Infinity Ward. And really, the implications, the natural extension of that logic that Woody and other people, again, displayed in their videos about 402, is that Robert Bowling was barely even associated with Infinity Ward. He was barely even associated with the game, and he was just some guy that we were picking on, and how dare we pick on him because he didn't really have anything to do with it, and he was just some guy out selling churros in front of the Infinity Ward office, and we found his Twitter, and blah, 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 blah. Now, here's the thing. And I tried my best to point this out in the comments, but I think it's something that people need to have pointed out to them. And I could come at this from a few different ways, and I'm not sure exactly how to do it, because obviously I could, the first reaction I had was to just be baffled and bewildered by the notion that so many people, like these Woody's Gamer or Team Gamertag bozos out there, that take whatever Woody says as gospel. Now, this isn't, again, this isn't hating on Woody at all. It's just a natural extension of what he does, and I don't think he really has played a huge part in it outside of, you know, just making videos, but I don't think he makes people do this. But for some reason, there's a large contingent of these bozos out there on YouTube that take anything and everything he and other similar YouTubers — I don't mean to single out Woody, and again, I have no problem with Woody — but these people seize on whatever they say, and they take it and treat it as gospel. And not only do they take it and treat it as gospel for themselves, for personal reflection and thought, but they try to preach it to other people. And so I am involved when those bozos come onto my videos and try to tell me how things actually are. Here's the deal. Robert Bowling — well, of course, I was bewildered by that. I mean, I was just baffled. I was like, really? And of course, I had to ask, I'm like, do people do this with what I say, and I just don't see it? Which I mean, is fine with me, because I'm right way more often than not, and I'm right way more often than other people on YouTube. I'm just kidding. No, but seriously, I'm a lot smarter than most people. But anyway, I wanted to tell people, look, here's Robert Bowling's job. Robert Bowling is not a community manager. The job that Woody's Gamer Tag and a lot of other people described is the job of a community manager, just a middleman. He's just a guy that takes the unadulterated thought of the community and rage and turns it into marching orders for or into suggestions, not just suggestions, for the developers at the respective gaming companies. And that's not what Robert Bowling was. He actually was responsible for creating and delivering marching orders for those developers. Was he a coder? Was he involved deep in the trenches on the development side? Was he sitting in front of a computer writing code? I don't know. I don't know how deep his technical knowledge runs, but I do know that, number one, he distanced himself repeatedly from the community manager title and repeatedly stressed that he was a creative strategist. And he repeatedly also stressed that he was responsible for giving the marching orders and the direction for the Modern Warfare series. So before you start taking whatever these ass-kissing YouTubers out there, because again, like I said in a comment, they all secretly wish to be whisked away from YouTube and be made salaried consultants on the development side, because that job pays a lot more, and it's a lot more, there's a lot more security involved in it. And again, there's nothing wrong with that. That's yeah. I mean, I'd take a job on the dev side if I was a salaried consultant. Hell yeah. So would everybody. I'd be stupid not to, and that's nothing wrong with them. But before you start taking everything they say as gospel, you need to understand, first of all, that they have a vesting interest in their side from saying what they say, and also you need to understand that what they are saying, specifically in this case that Robert Bowling was just a community manager, directly contradicts what Robert Bowling himself has said. So keep that in mind. And understand that going forward, and hopefully this will turn some people to turn a cautious eye towards the words of others, the assertions of others in the YouTube community. But anyway, guys, that's my time. I got to get out of here. Thank you for joining. I hope you enjoyed. Be sure to drop a like on this video if you did enjoy. I am out.